Look at this beautiful photo of Los Angeles. This is the final result that you're gonna learn in this video if you stay till the end. This is the before, it's an HDR, and this is the final result. I'm gonna be using the new plugin called Magic Light in Luminar Neo at the end of this video. Check it out, it's gonna blow your mind. All right, so let's get started. So you can select all three photos. It's a really cool HDR shot with a Sony camera of downtown Los Angeles, taken from the Griffith Park, one of my favorite spots. If you ever go to Los Angeles, you got to check out that spot. Having the observatory as a foreground element is really cool. So I'm going to double click on the photo to start retouching it. So that's the HDR. You know, all three raw files being combined into one exposure. And now I can go to the edit section and I can edit it. So usually what I like to do is I like to start by the develop module, and you'll see, you know, as I said, I'm going to use the magic light at the end. You'll see it's really cool. It adds that little magic. I mean, this software is just getting better and better. It's incredible. I find that I use it now about in 80% of all my photos. So I'm going to do some smart contrast because I'm smart. And then I open the shadow a little bit. Well, on this one, maybe not so much the shadows. Bring down a bit the highlights. Yes. I want to give like a night feeling to the photo. So maybe I lower the exposure. I mean, it was shot at night, but the HDR made it like really like a daylight photo. And it's already right there. You can see the before and after. I mean, just a few sliders. I'm going to go to enhance. I love what accent is crazy. So accent, if you go all the way, it's gonna look really fake. But if you just add a bit of accent, it's kind of cool. Let's add also a bit of sky enhancer. Sky enhancer is gonna make it's gonna burn the sky, it's gonna make it a bit darker. So that's kind of cool. I find that the photo now is too blue. So what you can do is you can either add a develop on top of your develop, or you can go to edits and you can correct what you've been doing. So I can click here on my develop module and I can just go to colors. I think I'm on this one, I'm gonna maybe just lower a little bit the saturation, because at night you get very saturated photo. And I think I want to add a bit of magenta, maybe a bit of warm, just a bit of warm like this. Now, you know what? I like that the sky stays blue. So I'm going to keep like that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a landscape. They have this amazing landscape filter to bring back the warmth of the city. So I'm going to keep it very blue, maybe a bit more magenta because I'm a crazy magentic. I'm going to lower the saturation because you have to be careful when you take night photos. Photography at night can get very saturated, because the truth is night is very saturated, especially in Los Angeles. The colors become really vivid. There was no fog that night. It was really kind of cool. And then voila. So then let's go back to tools. And you see it's bringing back because I did enhance. So it's getting now very colorful again, but that's fine. At this point, I'll adjust the color at the end. I want to go to landscape and add the golden. Check what the golden hour does. I'm going to overdo it so you can see it's crazy. It adds a lot of warmth. So I'm going to do it a little bit, but I don't like what it does. I just like what it does in some part of the city. So then I'm just going to go to masking. I'm going to take a brush. And by default, you're going to paint the effect. So right now, the effect is everywhere, right? But if I lower the strands, increase the size, and I just paint the effect on the observatory here, again, if you get a chance, to go to the Griffith Park in Los Angeles. It's such a cool place at night. You hear all the coyotes going, woo, woo. It's really nice, but I love it. I just love it. And you see, I added the effect, and you can see here before and after the effect. It's very subtle. It just makes the city a little more warmer. Actually, I think I want to make it stronger. I'm going to maybe make it a bit stronger. The colors are getting crazy, but that's fine. We'll readjust the colors at the end. That's how I work with Luminar. On this one, I really want to crop the photo because I don't like this part of the park. I really want to get closer to the Griffith Park, to the observatory. So let's go to the crop tool. And I'm going to crop this 16:9. So I go here, 16:9. And then I really want to go rule of third on the observatory. Maybe I want to align the horizon here on the rule of third. Look at that. 2/3 of the city, 1/3 of sky. I don't like that this building. So one of the rule of composition is you go around your photo and you make sure you don't have something that's very important that's sort of half in and half out. I kind of like this light here. I don't want to lose them. Cropping is an art. I'm telling you, cropping is an art. See, now we are, yeah, you see, I don't like what I did here. I can go back to my crop. I really want to get these lights heat in here. So I'm going to go a little wider like that. Yes. Yeah, I wanted to get these lights in here because I kind of like that. Here, I don't like it because the camera, the long exposure made this very bright, but it was very dark to my eyes. So I'm going to re-darken that. Okay, so the next thing I always do is a super contrast. Super contrast is crazy. It's going to make the photo very oversaturated, but then I'm going to correct the lights, highlights, midtones, and shadows. What it does, it adds a lot of contrast to the photo. So look at that, before and after. But it makes the color also a little too crazy. I don't like when the colors are too crazy, so I'm going to go back to color now for my final thing, and I'm just going to go to remove color cast. I like what that does. It also makes the photo darker. And then I'm going to take out some vibrance to make it less saturated. So it's like more natural. Boom. I think I'm going to go to here to color our harmony. And I want to maybe just add back a bit of warmth. I don't know. Or if you go right, you add warmth. If you go left, you make blue. Maybe it's just a little bit of warmth like that. And when the photo becomes blurry, that's totally fine. That's just, you know, what it's while it's working. But then as soon as you stop, it's finished. Okay, let's go to dodge and burn because I want to dodge and burn. So the way dodge and burn works, you have a brush. I'm going to make the strength pretty low, size pretty big. I'm going to go to darken. I want to darken this whole section here. It was very dark to my eyes. I don't know why the raw file came out so bright, you know, because it's a long exposure, I'm guessing. It's just I want to darken that a little bit, so I'm just going to do that. I think I'm going to maybe darken a little bit the top of the sky like this. Yeah, just a tad. Voila, something like that. And I'm already really loving the photo, but I'm not done. So I want to do one more thing to it, which I really love. They have this new magic light. Check it out. It's really made for this kind of photo. If you boost the intensity, what it's going to do, it's going to, look at this, what it does here. It takes all the CD lights and make like a sparkle on it. And which I love. It's an effect you can either get using the, putting your camera like F22, F16 is going to make the same effect. Or you can use that filter. You know what's funny is that people say, oh yeah, but it's not okay. You're retouching the photo. But you see, when you put your camera at F16 and you get the effect, you're distorting reality. It's the F16 that's making the lights like this, right? So, or if you use a wide angle, it's distorting reality. Or if you do a long exposure, you're distorting reality with an ND filter. So if you distort reality with a filter or with an f-stop or with a wide angle, is it okay to do that versus distorting reality in the software? It's a debate. That we can talk about. So check it out. You have a lot of feature in this new magic light. You've got size. You can make the sparking bigger or smaller. It's really good for seed lights. Beam width. Look at this one. This is going to make the beam either bigger or smaller. Glow is going to make them glower, you know, more glowy, less glowy. Clearingness, it's kind of cool. I actually like pretty sharp glow like this. I just don't like this one. This one is too big. Well, this is too clear. It is too clear, maybe something like this. Check this out, number of beams. You can go number of beams. Maybe not that crazy, but maybe a little more. It's kind of cool. Rotation, you can rotate them. That's so cool. And this one is, the intensity is way too much. I'm going to lower the intensity. I'm going to lower the size of the beams. I just wanted to be there, but like when you do a big print like this, it's going to make a huge difference to have this thing sparkle. And like, I don't like this one. I like everyone, but I don't like this one. And again, you can just go to masking, brush. By default, you can go to erase, and then I can just erase this one, wait for it, and boom, this one is gone, and I have the effect. Check it out, everywhere except this big one there. It's kind of sold, but it's beautiful. Okay, I cannot stop this video, so I can stop here, which is kind of a pretty natural retouching. This is the final result, which I really like. Or I can go crazy. I can go to sky, and I'm going to use one of my Florida sky, like this one, for example, with the moon. And because at the end of the day, I don't really like that sky. And let's see here. The sky orientation. I want to see the moon. Let's put the moon here, right here. Look at that. Boom. Now, maybe a little higher up. Yeah, just like that, right in the middle. Isn't that cool? And you don't have to do this if you hate sky placement. But if you're like me, you know, I was talking to, this is the before and this is after. It's kind of crazy. I was talking to the gallery I work with in Paris, and they said that the best selling photos right now are the photos which are very, very retouched. Because I think what's happening is the phones became so good. Well, actually, let me show you. This is a gallery I work with, Yellow Corner, and like, for example, this photo is one of their best selling photo ever, which is like heavy Photoshop. This one is like heavy HDR. This is some of their best selling work. This is the photo that sold the most for the last 25 years. Extremely Photoshop. I believe all the balloons were added by Photoshop. So, you know, look at this one also, which is like absolutely beautiful, but it's, you know, it's not natural. It's a lot of, you know, compositing and stuff like that. You see, people love extraordinary, you know, they love, and you know, sometimes you get very natural work. Photography is all about creation. Anyway, also, if you want to get Luminar, you can get $10 off. If you go to Luminar, the link under the video, if you use the code SURGE, so for example, you can either buy it by months, by year, or a lifetime. If you don't want to have subscription, you can just pay a lifetime. For example, you click on buy now. And if you use the code SURGE, so for example, it's $149, you enter promotional code SURGE. I get a small commission. You get $10 off. It's a win-win. I do get paid for doing this video, but I'll tell you something. Because I have a very big channel with over 600,000 subscribers, I get 4 offer sponsorships per day, 1,000 a year. And I only accept the software that I really use. And Luminar Neo, I've been using for real. Absolutely for real. Anyway, give me a little like if you like this kind of videos. And check out this other video that I did on Luminar Neo, which is a complete makeover also. But this time, it's a landscape. The video should be starting around there right now.